Hello there, everybody. I'm Briggs here, and we are not in my studio again, but I have the light pointing towards my city. And in my last city update, where I kind of showed this whole area, I said the next thing I'd be showing you guys was this, but I completely forgot to do this. It's always been the plan that after I showed you kind of everything, I would show you just overall walkthrough of everything as it stands right now. The date is, I believe, February 26th or 27th. Just check down below the date this was published. It should be a day before that, and when I'm recording this. So, yeah, let's just go in through the whole walkthrough, starting with, well, let's get the new thing. So I'm gonna do this out of order. You know, this is definitely still a work in progress, and this is kind of my whole amusement park area section. So here we have the kind of a circus looking gateway. Behind that we got a ticket booth, and inside, just removing a bit of the roof, this is work in progress. All the pieces have to be changed out, but you got two cash registers and a bunch of 1x2 printed ticket tiles. Or actually, most of this has to be changed out, not all of it. Here we have the kind of upside down roller coaster. It's hung up by these sort of beams, and you have, yeah, all the tracks pieces are upside down, and you have the carts with chairs coming from the bottom, or seats, and this is one of the rides where your feet would hang. Sorry, I still have a bit of a cold, that's why I keep clearing my throat. But here's a very much work in progress kind of swinging build. I'm gonna have to fix that later. Back there we got this kind of cutting candy stand. Yep, still work in progress. An ice cream kind of a freezer. There we have a place that sells drinks and popcorn and slushies, evidently with that cup. We have the line and the kind of operating booth for the roller coaster. That is that, and I forgot to show this when I showed you guys my whole city, but yeah, it's getting interference right there, so I gotta change that out, but that's basically how it works, just simple. Here we have the drop ride, which is very, very much work in progress. You know, some stuff are looking more complete. Here is the river rafting ride. Got a couple of stuff, you know, the stairway, the line, and then the rafts themselves. I still need a bunch of 1x1 transparent studs to fill in this kind of area and some more pieces for the line itself. There's my work in progress thing. Can't show you it too long, because it's gonna be kind of a surprise for later. But let's go onward to the park then. Yeah, the park. So this is just the city layout as it stands right now. And actually, before the park, that's my kind of construction mock. Yeah, it's a part of my city. I put it there when, you know, I'm working on something. I should put it in here actually, so have to do that eventually. Here is the park. And let's see what we got here. So onto this side, we got the sort of basketball court, a dumpster right there with a couple of bones in it. I can't open it with one hand. There we go. We got the little skateboarding ramp with a skateboarder. Hopefully he won't crash into that whole hot dog cart. That looks pretty good. We got the sort of basketball area. Don't worry, this isn't an in-depth walkthrough if you can't already tell. It will only take a few minutes. Fruit stand, a guy kind of getting paid probably to manage the park. We got another guy over there. A lemonade stand and a picnic table. There we have a rock climbing wall, great eagle flying overhead, monkey bars, a bike rack, a trash can, and this sort of assembly where you'd climb up and then slide down, a couple of benches knocked over. A seesaw, a swing, a seesaw or teeter-totter, whatever you want to call it. And then a sandbox, another bench, a merry-go-round, and there's the other guy getting paid to kind of rake the leaves of the trees, so those don't look like they'd fall off. And a grandfather just watching his kids, or maybe just enjoying the park. Here is the beach. We got the kind of lifeguard stand right here with some flotation devices or floaters, and we got some life vests, some beach chairs with umbrellas. We have this kind of a volleyball net. We have an ice cream stand back there, and the inside has some cones, On the inside of the scuba diving stand has really nothing, but on the outside you could see the air tank, the life vest, the snorkeling gear, and then the kind of fins. What else we got? We got a little sandcastle. Let's move Superman, his cameo, out of the way. So we got that right there. The shore is done nicely with a lot of transparent pieces and some one-by-one white studs to show the sea foam. We got the security patrol just watching over the beach. And here is the kind of ocean part. We got this rock with the turtle and a nice kind of squid build. Some people in the water, some fishes, some people swimming. That's how her other side looks. All the figures are custom, by the way. And two heads just in the water, so that's real deep right there. And then we have a road going across with a couple of four-wheelers, kind of off-road car buggy jeep thing. And then a car, one-seater car, the kind of huge oversized speed bump, traffic light, and two more cars and parking space all around this kind of road. So here we got the clothes store with some street lamps, and you can just see this is kind of the shopping street, how the sidewalk goes across all the way. And yeah, here's the clothes store. We got the logo, the little signs. The roof is removable. Let's just try to get in here. Maybe I can. Yeah. So yeah, flip this kind of backwards, zoom out a bit. Hopefully, yeah. This whole thing will be pulled off. I won't bother taking the roof off right now, but you got some clothes back there. There's the display for the wedding dresses. There's some dress pieces back there, a revolving door. Let's see, we got a bunch of pants even on the other side, and some kind of caps slash hats, and I'll fix this later, you know. I just want to get the overview done real quickly. We got a toy store here, nice sign and striped kind of feel. And I am gonna be showing interiors quickly. And here on the inside, you enter through the door. You got some drones up there, some painting supplies with two paintbrushes and a bunch of paper, a Lego set and pick-a-brick. And on the opposite side, we have got a kind of train and a bulldozer. We got some helmets slash masks for play, and the gift wrapping counter with the wrapping paper selections in the back and some gifts slash checkout counter. Got a bunch of action figures, as micro figures, or this kind of bigger board game figures, as I call them. And a Ninjago place with a bunch of kind of swords, katanas, shurikens, and the training dummy, viable training dummy. There is the McDonald's for food in the city. It's a bit stuck. There we go. We'll just lay that down. I'll fix that later. A figure got caught in my microphone wire and pulled him right off the beach. But anyway, in here, once you entered, you got two seats and two tables, a bunch of sandwiches right here behind the counter, a drink fountain, some cups. There's the grill. That's where you'd wash your hands, and that's where you kind of do all the paying slash. I just have a to-go window, though it is kind of covered off by this right here. And that building, if you don't already know, is the furniture store. And by the way, all of this, I've shown it all in like separate videos, piece by piece, like the beach in one video, the park in one video, all the stores separately. For more in-depth videos, go check those out. This is just the kind of full walkthrough. You got an ATM there between the two buildings that actually works. And then, you know, the feature is behind it in that open space. You got the kind of bathroom right here. Let's zoom in a bit. And the door, I always pull it off, but there is the kind of toilet seat if you did want to see that. And then we got another street lamp. Sorry about the focus. Some more sidewalking, a bicycle. Still, I need to add a bunch of figures into this, but the roof of the grocery store does lift off just like that. And inside you got a freezer. We got some milk in there, kind of bread section, the croissant fell, some canned soup slash corn, sausages in there, and other meats. Here by the door we have shopping baskets and a bunch of kind of fruit. And there is the checkout counter where you have a little scale to weigh the all the fruits that you are going to be buying. Here is the arcade. I just knocked off the bicycle that's supposed to be coming off the A. Well, definitely one of my favorites. So it says arcade right there. You see the design and the roof lifts up in a different way than what I've been doing. Yeah, just like that. So anyway, inside, this is, yeah, again, one of my favorite places. It opens there. You have the open 24 hours. Oh, by the way, we have a little alleyway going in between these two buildings. But anyway, in here, right there is the prize counter where you'd put in tickets and where you pay to play the games. So you got guns, toy guns, obviously, bows, and a bunch of those figures, board game figures, and you can purchase drinks. And by the way, I hate the card systems arcades do. So yeah, this still a bit newer, like token system. You don't put coins, you put tokens. So yeah, that's just the way that works. And back there you have a kind of dance game that it looks kind of fun. You got a motorcycle game, and this actually moves a bit. It's on a couple of hinges, and that's the screen, and it fell off right there. Definitely got to clean this place up after the video. You can see how all the roofs are still off. But back there you have a two-person first-person shooter game. One of those hammer games where you slam the hammer down, try to get to the top. A joystick game, two of them actually, and another one-person first-person shooter game. My favorite machine and probably most complex build in the city, the claw machine. For a more in-depth look, again, see the arcade mock full video where I actually bring that out. And then a kind of driving racing game. And we have another flower path, so yeah, paths along both sides of the arcade. And that one leads to a fair. We got a ring toss game, a kind of water target shooting game. One of those games where you add up the numbers, choosing randomly from the kind of floating things. Usually they're rubber ducks or duckies, but yeah, it was near Halloween when I made that. There's a ball toss game. Need to do some modification right there. But here is what I call the New York Street. It's mainly, I just got a lot of inspiration off it from New York. But we got a flower count, a kind of magazine slash newspapers, little, what are these called? I forgot, but right there, we got a place that sells sweets. There we got a kind of meat place. Inside is nothing special, just a kind of stove and, you know, a sink, just a small sink. And off here we have a kind of bus stop. Yeah, maybe there's supposed to be another road here. I didn't really think about that. In that tiny corner, obviously blocked off now before this place was open, is a tiny payphone. I do have a working play feature. And again, if you want to see that, see the more in-depth video. It's actually only a minute long. But here's the tool store. Thor's hammer, as I call it. It's a reference to when I reviewed that and gave that hammer to Thor. And then this opens out. And there's the tool store. Nothing on the wall with the door right there. Though we got a bunch of wrenches, hammer, a drill, some specialized tools, a little gasoline-filled thing, a key. You know, they make keys here. And then a wood cutting machine and some more kind of tools in the back. And then moving this right here, we've actually got a furniture store. Another one of my favorites ever to build. Or I don't know, not to build. It was kind of fun to build. Yeah, really fun actually designing the furniture. But it's just a place I really like in my mock city. And inside we got two beds. They're the Sensei Wu style ones from Destiny's Bounty where they open, put a figure inside, and the blanket closes. You got a couch, you got a recliner, you got a dresser, you got a lamp, you got a checkout, and a tiny table right there. But wow, is that really it? So yeah, I'm gonna have to kind of cut the camera, and then I'm gonna put the roofs back on and then do a kind of overview, just talking about it for a little bit. So anyway, I kind of fixed up my city and it's time for the kind of overview. And the next thing that I really got to do in terms of the city, not in terms of like videos and all that, is I want to work on housing. Yeah, like houses and apartments, maybe just one apartment building, like two base plates long, just to give my figures a place to stay. Probably got to get another road back here as well. And it's definitely fun to build all this stuff. I really like the toy shop, the furniture store, and the arcade. And yeah, the park was fun. The amusement park was actually really fun to design. I love designing the rides. And I definitely have to kind of fix that up. But yeah, there's probably more to come and a lot more I have to do there. But Yeah, that is it for this video. I hope you liked it. Please subscribe, leave a comment down below, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye.